Come we before him and rejoice. Know that the Lord is God in thee. Without our redeeming us make, we are his folk, he does us be. And for his sheep he does us take.
Today we gather for Palm Sunday in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. May the peace of the Lord be with each of you.
And with your spirit.
Let us put ourselves before God's mercy. Lord Jesus, you come as a light in the midst of darkness. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you come as healing in the midst of brokenness. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you come as wisdom in the midst of difficulty. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, who is an example of humility for the human race to follow, cause our Savior to take flesh and submit to the cross, graciously grant that we may learn from his lessons of patient suffering. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The servant of the Lord said, "The Lord God has given me the tongue of a teacher, that I may know how to sustain the weary with a word. Morning by morning he wakens my ear to listen as those who are taught. The Lord God has opened my ear, and I was not rebellious. I did not turn backward. I gave my back to those who struck me, and my cheeks to those who pulled out the beard. I did not hide my face from insult and spitting. The Lord God helps me. Therefore, I have not been disgraced. Therefore, I have set my face like flint, and I know that I shall not be put to shame. My brothers and sisters, word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. Christ Jesus, though he was in the form of God, did not regard equality with God as something to be exploited, but emptied himself, taking the form of a slave, being born in human likeness. And being found in human form, he humbled himself and became obedient to the point of death, even death on a cross. Therefore, God highly exalted him and gave him the name that is above every name, so that at the name of Jesus, every knee should bend in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. My brothers and sisters, word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Praise to you, Lord, Jesus Christ, King of endless glory, King of endless glory. Praise to you, Lord, Jesus Christ, King of endless glory. Christ became obedient.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Now Jesus stood before the governor, and the governor asked him, "Are you the king of the Jews?" Jesus said, "You say so." But when he was accused by the chief priests and the elders, he did not answer. And then Pilate said to him, "Do you not hear how many accusations they make against you? But you have given no answer, not even to a single charge." So that the governor was greatly amused. Now, at the festival, the governor was accustomed to releasing a prisoner from the crowd, for the crowd, anyone they wanted. And at that time, they had a notorious prisoner called Barabbas. So after they had gathered, Pilate said to them, "Who do you want me to release for you, Barabbas or the Jew who was called Jesus?" He realized that it was out of jealousy that they had handed him over. While he was sitting on the judgment seat, his wife sent word to him, "Have nothing to do with that innocent man, for today I suffered a great deal because of a dream about him." Now the chief priests and the elders persuaded the crowds to ask for Barabbas and to have Jesus killed. The governor again said to them, "Which one of the two do you want me to release?" And they said, "Barabbas." Pilate said to them, "Then what should I do with Jesus who is called the Christ?" And all of them said, "Let him be crucified." Then he asked, "Why? What evil has he done?" But they shouted all the more, "Let him be crucified." So when Pilate saw that he could do nothing, but rather that a riot was beginning, he took some water, washed his hands before the crowd, saying, "I am innocent of this man's blood. See to it yourselves." Then the people as a whole answered, "His blood is on us and on our children." So he released Barabbas for them. After flogging Jesus, he handed him over to be crucified. Then the soldiers of the governor took Jesus into the governor's headquarters, and they gathered the whole cohort around him. They stripped him and put a scarlet robe on him, and after twisting some thorns into a crown, they put it on his head. They put a reed in his hand and knelt before him and mocked him, saying, "Hail, King of the Jews!" They spat on him and took the reed and struck him in the head. After mocking him, they stripped him of the robe and put his own clothes on him. Then they led him away to be crucified. As they went out, they came upon a man from Cyrene named Simeon, and they compelled this man to carry his cross. And when they came to a place called Golgotha, which means the place of the skulls, they offered him wine to drink, mixed with gall. But when he tasted it, he would not drink it. And when they had crucified him, they divided his clothes among themselves by casting lots. Then they sat down and they kept watch over him. Over his head, they put the charge against him, which read, "This is Jesus, the King of the Jews." Then two bandits were crucified with him, one on his right and one on his left. Those who passed by derided him, shaking their heads and saying, "You who would destroy the temple and build it in 3 days, save yourself. If you are the Son of God, come down from the cross." In the same way, the chief priests also, along with the scribes and elders, were mocking him. "He saved others. He cannot save himself. He is the King of Israel. Let him come down from the cross now, and we will believe in him." He trusts in God. Let God deliver him now if he wants to, for he said, I am the Son of God. The bandits who were crucified also taunted him in the same way. From noon on, darkness came over the whole land until about 3 in the afternoon. And about 3 o'clock, Jesus cried out in a loud voice, Ali, Ali, alum sabachthani, which is, my God, why have you forsaken me? When some of the bystanders heard it, they said, this man is calling on Elijah. At once, one of them ran and got a sponge, filled it with sour wine, put it on a stick, and gave it to him to drink. But the other said, wait, let's see if Elijah will come and save him. Jesus cried again with a loud voice and breathed his last. At that moment, the curtain of the temple was torn into two. From top to bottom, the earth shook and the rocks were split. The tombs were also open, and many bodies of the saints who had fallen asleep were raised. And after his resurrection, they came out of the tomb and entered the holy city and appeared to many. Now, when the centurion and those with him were keeping watch over Jesus, saw the earthquake and what took place, they were terrified and said, truly, this man was God's son. My brothers and sisters, our salvation, the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
And the Lord has given me the tongue of a teacher, that I may know how to sustain the weary with the word. Morning by morning, he wakens. He wakens my ear to listen to those who are taught. The Lord God has opened my ear. The prophet Isaiah is reminding us that the power, somebody say power.
Power.
Of the word comes from God. Amen?
Amen.
That God will give us the words of everlasting life. The words of peace and not war. The words of justice and not vindication. The words of love and not hate. God has given me the tongue of a teacher. Amen?
Amen.
There is power, somebody say power,
power,
in the word of God. These words that we speak to one another, words of greetings, hello, goodbye, thank you, you're welcome, words that bring people in. These are the words we teach our children. These are the words that we should expect to hear from those who lead us in civil life, those who lead us in religious life, those who teach our children, those who stand for us and speak for us, must speak the words of joy, not sorrow, the words of comfort in times of sorrow. There is power, somebody say power,
power,
in the words. But with power, you can choose to use that power for good or for ill. You can choose to use words that lift up or tear down. The Lord God has given me the tongue of a teacher. The endurance of a word. To this very day, I can hear the words of my mother. Don't forget where you come from. I can still hear the words of my father. Move. I ain't no glass maker. These words make me smile. These words cross generations and time and distance and life and death. During this Easter season, let's resurrect our vocabulary. Let's raise up words of goodwill. Let's speak from the kindness of our heart. Let's speak from our joy. There is power, somebody say power.
Power.
In the words. One of the most powerful words in the world is that word we all know and sometimes fear. Because that word has an obligation attached to it. That word has a promise attached to it. That word, whether it is agape or philia, the word love is so powerful. And so I want to leave you today with the assurance that I love you, and so does God, and there's not a thing you can do about it. Amen.
Let's pray together our belief. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified and Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us present to the Lord our needs. For all those preparing for the Easter sacraments of baptism, confirmation, and Eucharist, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peace in the Middle East, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
I invite you to lift up your own needs and concerns. Lord God, we present to you all the needs that weigh at our hearts. We make them known through your Son, Jesus, who lives with us and through us now and forever. Amen. So we prepare the altar. I again thank all of you for your generosity. It is your generosity that helps us at St. Martin's to be generous to many people. Lord God, we ask that you bless this bread, this wine, fruit of the field, and fruit of the vine, so it soon becomes the very body and blood of Jesus.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my friends, that my sacrifice and yours become acceptable to God, the Father Almighty.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at our hands for the praise and the glory of his name, for our good and all his holy church.
Through the passion of your only begotten Son, O Lord, may our reconciliation with you be near at hand, so that though we do not merit it by our own deeds, yet by the sacrifice made once for all, we may feel already the effects of your mercy through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just. Our duty and salvation always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through your Son Jesus. For though innocent, Jesus suffered willingly for sinners and accepted unjust condemnation to save the guilty. His death has washed away our sins. His resurrection has purchased for us our justification. We join all the angels as we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit, that they become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. The time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which we poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." And let us proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died.
Christ is risen.
Christ will come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life, the chalice of salvation, giving thanks you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Wilton, our Bishop, and all of the women and men who lead and guide the church. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, the blessed apostles, Martin, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ, through him, with him, in him. O God, Almighty Father, the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us pray for the fullness of God's kingdom as we say, Our Father
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever.
Amen.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace. My peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace and unity of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
And may the peace of the Lord be with each of you.
And with your spirit.
I invite those who to share the sign of God's peace with those people around you. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. I invite you to spiritually give God thanks and praise that God loves us no matter what we do, that God always loves us. This is the body of Christ.
Amen.
Let us break bread together on our knees. Let us break bread together on our knees. When I fall on my knees with my face to the rising sun, when I fall together on our knees. When I fall on my knees with my face to the rising sun, when I fall on my knees with my face to the rising sun, oh Lord, have mercy on me. Let us praise God together on our knees. When I fall on my knees with my face to the rising sun, when I fall on my knees with my face to the rising sun, oh Lord, oh, Lord.
Let us pray. Nourished by these sacred gifts, we humbly beseech you, O Lord, that just as through the death of your Son, you have brought us hope for what we believe, so by his resurrection you may lead us to where we are called through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
I invite you to pray with me our family prayer for justice, human dignity, crafted by the Archdiocese of Washington. Loving and faithful God, we come to you, Father, to ask it through your Son, Jesus, and a communion with the Holy Spirit. You help us in the battle against America's original sin of racism that divides us from being the body of Christ that we are called to be as your children. We implore you to give us your wisdom so that we may build a community founded on the gospel message of the life and dignity of all people, from the womb to the tomb, and to live in communion like the divine communion of the Holy Trinity. Bless parents that they may form their children in faith to love one another, regardless of skin color, ethnicity, and national origin, just as Jesus loves us. Bless and protect all of us as we live out our faith and be an instrument of your peace, as St. Francis said. Fill us with a thirst for justice and righteousness. Hear our prayer and give us the courage, compassion, and perseverance to root out any form of injustice within our communities and to bring the healing love of Christ to all in need. Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of our Church, hasten to help us and intercede on our behalf so that our archdiocese can continue to witness to the gospel message the life and dignity of all people.
Amen.
Our announcements this coming Sunday, we have one Mass at Palm Sunday at 10 a.m., so if you have any of your family coming to church, it's 10 o'clock this Sunday. Afterwards, we'll continue our tradition the last few years, actually, since COVID. We do our palms and alms, so between 12 o'clock and 1 o'clock, if you can drive by and get your palms. If you want to give us your alms, that works too. Our Holy Week schedule, Holy Thursday, March 28th, 7:30 at night. That's when we wash the feet of anyone who wants to come forward, and we'll go and hopefully do a procession to take Jesus downstairs for our little altar in the Pioneer Room, and then so it's basically Mass, washing the feet, and the procession. Good Friday, there's two things. We have the Stations of the Cross, which we release at 12 noon. It's our neighborhood Stations of the Cross that we've been doing for years, but this is now virtual. And the evening at 7:30 is our Passion of our Lord Jesus Christ again, this time by the Gospel from John. So that's at 7:30. Easter Vigil is 7:30 also. You get a pattern here at 7:30 every night. Easter Vigil, we will finally get around to the celebrations of Confirmation, Baptism, Eucharist for the folks who've been getting ready for a while. Easter Sunday, two Masses, 9 o'clock and 12 noon. We get back to our regular schedule. So if you're able to join us. This coming weekend is the last weekend for Lilies in Memory of Loved Ones. We need that by Palm Sunday before the day's over with. Exercise class won't be this coming Thursday. Next Thursday, Holy Thursday, but it'll be the following week, which is, I think, April the 4th, and we'll continue on for another 4 weeks. It's free of charge at 6 o'clock on Thursdays down in the Pioneer Room. And this Good Friday, we have a fish fry from 12 to 2, and there's a trip to Greece that one of our parishioners is sponsoring October 7th to 15th. There's details about the bulletin. Birthdays. I'm not sure I know any birthdays. That's it. Okay. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May the Lord continue to open our eyes and our heart to see how much God loves us and allow us to love each other. Let the church say,
Amen.
May the Lord give blessing in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
My Lord King Jesus, no man can ever know me. My Lord King Jesus, why not? No man cannot hinder me. For he is King of Kings, he is Lord of Lords. Jesus Christ, the first and last, no man works like him. For he is King of Kings, he is Lord of Lords. Jesus Christ, the first and last, no man works like him. King Jesus rides a milk-white horse, no man works like him. The river of Jordan he did cross, no man works like him. For he is King of Kings, Lord of Lords. Oh, Jesus Christ, the first and last, oh. King Jesus.
Jesus Christ in the middle of the air. Oh, he calls the saints from everywhere. Oh, Lord, Lord, King Jesus, no man cannot hinder me. King Jesus, ride on, no man cannot hinder me. He is the King, he is the Lord. Oh, yes, he is the King, he is the